quiet, pretty village was once the setting for one of the most famous executions of a queen in British history. Intrigued? Well, don't lose your head over it. I'll reveal all in a moment. Today's show, it's my mission to help a retired couple find a slice of country life closer to their family, and they'll need to hold their breath for some breathtaking properties.
Do I sigh again?
I think you should, but maybe louder than you have before. Today I'm in Northamptonshire in the village of Fotheringhay, which in the 16th century was dominated by a great castle. Today only these ruins behind me remain. But it was here in the Great Hall in 1587 that Mary, Queen of Scots, was beheaded on the orders of her cousin Queen Elizabeth I. Now, eyewitness accounts from the time tell the gruesome tale of the executioner taking two blows with the axe to perform the deathly deed. And when he lifted her severed head to the crowd, her wig came away to reveal that her hair was cut short to the scalp. Well, dramatic deaths aside, this county is also packed with heritage that'll warm the soul. Landlocked in the heart of England, Northamptonshire is bordered by eight other counties, including a tiny 19-metre stretch that's shared with Lincolnshire, making it the shortest county boundary in the country. Much of Northamptonshire's beautiful rural landscape has been shaped by farming, but also provides fantastic walking territory, in particular the 70-mile footpath of the Nen Valley Way that runs adjacent to the River Nen. The river flows serenely through many attractive villages and towns, including the historic market town of Oundle, whose impressive array of 17th and 18th century limestone buildings make it clear to see why Northamptonshire is known as the county of spires and squires. For many centuries, the main industry was the manufacture of shoes and boots, and this legacy has been preserved in Northampton's newly refurbished museum, featuring the world's largest collection of shoes at over 12,000 pairs. And with fascinating historic locations offering easy access to glorious unspoilt countryside, it's easy to understand why Northamptonshire is a shoo-in for aspiring escapees. House prices here in Northamptonshire vary across the county. Now, you may be interested to learn that a detached property will set you back £224,000. That's £27,000 below the national figure. But buyers beware, because property in the highly sought-after Golden Triangle, that's between Daventry, Toaster and Banbury, carry between a 10 and 20% premium. That's because they're in gorgeous countryside with good motorway links on the doorstep. Other hotspots in the county include Oundle, and for good value property, you should head towards the market towns of Wellingborough and Rushton. One thing Northamptonshire isn't short of is housing stock with style.
The Midlands counties have a rich bounty of building materials sourced from the underlying Jurassic rocks, and it's the Northampton sand that contains the distinctive ironstone used to construct many buildings in Northamptonshire, such as this four-bedroom listed home in Findon, currently on the market for £245,000. This region also showcases picture postcard cottages featuring the traditional style of thatched roofing. Known as long straw, it's fixed and finished with decorative crisscross lengths of hazel or willow called liggers. And at £465,000, this four-bedroom thatched cottage in the village of Barton Seagrave is a particularly fine example. Throughout the county, many pre-20th century properties are made of pale limestone and mellow brick, and this lovely listed terraced home in the sought-after village of Cranford comes with an asking price of £235,000.
Well, as you can see, there's certainly some great property shopping to be done in this county. Let's meet today's buyers and find out what they're looking for.
Husband and wife David and Sheila share a passion for travel. In fact, their relationship developed from a holiday romance overseas. But when it comes to their domestic itinerary, it's not always been an ideal destination.
We've been married for nearly 38 years. All our moves have been based around work considerations. We've finally got the chance to choose where we actually want to live, and not have to worry about being near an office or a railway station or a motorway.
They're both retired tax inspectors, so without the restrictions of work, the world is their oyster. However, at the centre of their world is their family, who all live some 3 hours' drive away from their current home in the Somerset town of Weston-super-Mare.
We never saw Weston-super-Mare as our retirement home. It was a stepping stone. Now that we're both retired, I retired 6 years ago, she was just retired. We have a grandson living up in Northampton, and we would love to spend more time with him.
We'd like to be able to help out.
We can be the nanny and grandpa who help out.
As well as being more hands-on grandparents, they're also hoping for more interaction with the locals.
So we would love to find a village.
The proper community that we can get involved in.
I think we miss the friendships, the camaraderie, the whole social scene of village life.
So the new house has to accommodate the potential for socialising with new neighbours and friends, as well as providing a place to stay for visiting family. And it also has to fit their recreational needs.
I'm very keen to get my knitting machine working again. I used to have my own little business, and perhaps that's something I'd look at doing again. In a perfect world, our next house would have 4 bedrooms and a study. That would mean that David could have his own study and I could have my own room for all my craft work and machine knitting. If we didn't have that, then we'd have a discussion about where I would be able to keep my knitting machine.
No, definitely not. My computer comes first.
And if David loses the battle, which I'm sure he will, then he knows the best way to let off steam.
For relaxation, I actually enjoy model railway. I got my first train set when I was about 4, which for many years, every time I set it up, we've moved and I've had to take it down again. This next move, hopefully I can then have a permanent trackway, complete with scenery, and enjoy a nice relaxing drive of trains.
Their house has just gone on the market and they've got all their finances in place for their Northamptonshire move.
Our budget for the new house is £400,000, but if you found the ideal house for us, then we might be able to stretch to £450,000.
Not only do David and Sheila desire a location closer to their grandson in Rushton, they also want easy access to their daughter in Lincolnshire. So our house search will concentrate on the serene villages towards the northern half of the county. I caught up with our buyers on the banks of the River Eye to discover a little bit more about the details of their move.
So go on then, what are we looking for in this retirement house for you both?
Well, my primary concern, I'm a model railway enthusiast, so I need something in the garden, an outbuilding, a shed, room for a shed, to house all my collection of trains. Other than that, house-wise, minimum 3 bedrooms.
I love it. So basically you're looking for a shed with a house attached to it.
Of course.
Pretty much, yes.
I'll forget about what you want. What do you want?
We'd like a minimum of 3 bedrooms with a study, or 4 bedrooms where we could convert one to a study. I hate open plan kitchen diners.
It's a very strong word, hate.
Yeah, okay. It is hate. I want a separate dining room.
Why?
I like to be able to shut it away when you finish the meal, and I don't like people around me when I'm cooking.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I hate people around me. I'm not a very good cook.
Right.
I like to make my mistakes in private.
She's better than she will admit to.
Oh, really?
I have to say.
Outside space?
Not too big, because we're not very good gardeners either.
What about the property itself? What do you want it to look like?
We've lived in 4 new builds, which are fine in their own right, but I like a character house.
Why are you smiling?
Because I actually prefer newer houses, so this could be interesting today.
Oh, right. So you want character, you want new. Yeah. Well, as always, we've got 3 properties to show you, one of them being the mystery property. I'm hoping you like all 3. Only time will tell. Let's get going. Come on.
For a top budget of £450,000, David and Sheila are looking for a 4-bedroom house that has the potential for both a craft room for a knitting machine and a games room for a model railway collection. They have specified a separate kitchen and dining room so no one can spy on Sheila as she cooks. And although they have differing opinions on the property style, they're both united in wanting a location within a thriving community. We have a variety of wonderful family homes lined up, but I'll keep our buyers guessing as to the price until the end of each tour. And as ever, we've got the Mystery House, which promises to derail their initial wish list and take them on an entirely different track. For the first property, we're destined for the village of Gretton, which is practically equidistant from their grandson and their daughter, with a travelling time of around 40 minutes to each. Gretton is a pretty village situated in the Welland Valley, which still retains its stocks and whipping post, though fortunately they haven't been used since the mid-1800s. The streets are lined with idyllic cottages, where it appears little has changed for hundreds of years. And there's plenty of opportunity to mingle with the residents at the local shop, in any of the three pubs, or at the coffee shop. So that's exactly where we're headed.
Morning, gents, ladies, how are you?
Hello.
Sorry to interrupt your coffee. It's a sleepy little village out there, but it's all going off in here, isn't it? This is where the party is.
It is.
I've got a couple of potential neighbours here. They haven't seen the house yet, so we're just showing them the village. So what's it like?
It's a fantastic village. I know...
There we go, we'll move in now.
It's a really good, kind, loving community.
So you'd recommend this village then?
100%.
We haven't even seen the house that they've got planned for us.
Oh, right.
But we're in.
But we love the coffee.
Well, I sort of retired up here from... I was principal baritone with New South as well as opera.
Wow! Do you fancy giving us a little serenade?
The pale moon was rising above the green mountain. The sun was declining beneath the blue sea. And my voice is...
Oh, it's brilliant. We'll leave you to it. Thank you very much, everyone. See you. All the best to you. See you later.
And after a welcoming serenade, it's high time we got to our first property, which is just a short stroll away from the high street, tucked down a quiet lane.
This is it. First property.
Okay. Yep. Reminds me of a picture postcard.
Perfect mixture of old and new. You like the old?
I do indeed, yes.
This bit's 1700s.
Just about right.
Right, yes. This bit for you. Your wing.
My wing. In that 1990s. Very nicely. Yeah.
Can you imagine yourself living here?
Yes, I can, but... I'll reserve.
No, don't say but. Don't say but. Don't hear but. You just say, yes, I can. That's fine. Yes, I can, but what?
I want to see the inside first.
Really? Okay, come on then. I'll show you the inside.
This historic but homely stone cottage has been extended and renovated over the years, but still maintains its traditional charm. So let's see what David and Sheila make of the abundance of original features inside.
I think this is lovely.
Yeah.
I don't usually like beams, but these are lighter than the ones you usually see.
Good headspace as well.
Plenty of headroom.
Yeah. Is this big enough for you?
Yes, this looks good. Yes. I love the window seat.
Good. I was hoping you'd say that. It's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes, I really like that.
So if you did the conventional knitting, you could do it there?
I do that, yeah.
But not with your great big machine?
Yeah. No, but I hand it as well.
Oh, you hand this as well?
Yes, I do.
Oh, so you'd be doing it there?
Yeah. Yes, that looks really nice.
Okay, well, let's move on. Let's go have a look at the kitchen. Well, the beam theme continues through to the kitchen.
It certainly does.
What do you think?
Yeah. It's okay. I'm not sure there's enough storage.
You got a lot of stuff?
I'm known as the gadget master.
Okay.
So we have gadgets all over the place.
Right.
And I'm not sure.
I'm not sure.
You've got quite a bit of workspace here, haven't
you? Just quite a bit, yeah.
It's not the work surfaces that's the problem, it's the cupboards. And I'm not sure there's enough storage space. That looks fine.
And of course you wanted a separate dining area.
Yes, definitely.
Well, I've got one with a lovely view to show you. Come
get.
What a sun trap.
This is lovely. It's so nice and warm.
And a nice large area to it.
It's big enough for you two, but it's also big enough for the grandchildren and family coming to visit as well.
I wouldn't want to use this as a dining room.
No?
No, I'd want to use this as a conservatory and have nice comfortable chairs out here where you could come and sit and read the paper on a Sunday.
Back off the hallway is a large utility and storeroom, next to a downstairs cloakroom, and an added bonus is yet another smaller reception room, featuring double doors to the garden. This room could provide an alternative space to dine, if Sheila could bear to sacrifice her much-desired craft and knit room. But of course there are options upstairs too. Alongside the modern and compact family bathroom, there are a total of four bedrooms that include a cosy double room, kitted out for a young boy, and a bright single designed for a young girl. But let's check out their potential room.